So, I have a lot of people asking me if they are gifted in jiu-jitsu, if they should continue jiu-jitsu, or if so, jiu-jitsu is something for them because they feel that they are not gifted, they have a hard time with jiu-jitsu and everything. So the first thing I want to tell you is that you can be the most gifted guy in the world, you're gonna still struggle with jiu-jitsu. And then I noticed that when people are talking about being gifted, they are talking about two ability that I call that the shining ability, or the ability that everybody see right away and everybody wish to have. But actually, they are not the most efficient ability. From my own experience, I saw a lot of people training. If you only have these two ability, you're gonna not go far in jiu-jitsu. You're gonna not go far at all. So the two shining ability are a fast learning, okay? So, and it's amazing when you see someone that can just watch a movement and know how to do it. I have students like that in my dojo, and I show him a movement, he do it two times and he know how to do it, no problem. So that's amazing. But it's not the most efficient ability. It's a very good and powerful ability. And if you reach a very high level, I'm talking really, really high, between maybe the 100 best in the world, you need that ability because otherwise you're gonna stagnate. So, but if you only have this ability and you don't have the rest of the ability that I'm gonna mention, there's no, you're gonna never reach even close to the 100 best, okay? The other one is a physical ability that everybody are like amazing. When someone is strong, fast, have a good cardio, these are amazing ability, are shining, everybody wish to have. And they are very useful, don't get me wrong, but they are just the tip of the iceberg, okay? They are the thing that you see. Okay, if you don't have the other ability that I'm gonna mention in another video, then you're just a shining thing that gonna never go very far, okay? So you need to understand that people that can be stronger and learn faster than you, it doesn't mean that they're gonna go further than you in jiu-jitsu, because you need other ability that are less shining, less amazing, but they are more important, okay? So I want you to remember that. The most important talent that you need in jiu-jitsu, it's discipline, okay? It's not shining, it's not when you imagine having a superpower, it's not the first that come, but trust me, discipline is the biggest superpower you can have in jiu-jitsu, and by the way, in everything in the fucking world, okay? So, what I mean to have discipline? Discipline is to be able to do something over and over and over again, to do it for a long time, and to do it no matter your state of mind, no matter what happened in your life, no matter your motivation. It's not motivation discipline. Discipline is, I'm gonna do that thing that I set up to do it, and I'm gonna do it no regardless what happened in my life. I'm gonna be on time, I'm gonna live on time, okay? And I'm gonna do that no matter what. That's important, okay? The second talent trait is a higher commitment. That means if you are disciplined and you come every one time a week, it's already amazing, okay? It's already fucking amazing. But it will not bring you, there's a limit of that. So higher commitment is the idea that I'm gonna put as many hours as I can, okay? I'm gonna do that thing as much as I can, no matter how I impact my life, no matter what happened, I'm gonna do that as much as I can to try to reach a higher level. And that's goal-oriented, okay? That means commitment is that I'm gonna do that as amount of time I decide to do it. But to have a higher commitment, that means you are goal oriented. You know exactly what you want, and that's the goal you want to reach, okay? And that's already, if you have that too, man, you are a monster. And maybe you don't have you have a hard time to learn jiu-jitsu, and you are not very physical, and your cardio so, and you know, physically and learning ability are slow. But if you have these two, man, it doesn't fucking matter. You're gonna be a badass. You're gonna beat the shit of so many people. And because if someone that learn fast doesn't have a high commitment, there's a moment where we're gonna plateau. There's a moment where everybody plateau, and the only people that keep improving are people that put more and more and more time, that continue to put the time, okay? And this is what it is. So the next big two talents are being teachable and intelligence. So being teachable, it's a very big shortcut. I see a lot of people that they are just not listening what I say, okay? A lot of white and blue belts that they are just like, when I tell them technique, it's just like, and not connecting, nothing, because they just want to roll, have fun, buddy. And they don't think that jiu-jitsu is about intelligence or about understand technique. And they are sabotaging themselves. They are making the learning jiu-jitsu and the learning the skill slower. Or people that I tell, oh, you have to do this, and they are not doing it for whatever reason, because they find that boring or whatever. This make them learn slower. And people that are more teachable are people that are going to improve a lot. And a lot in some books that I read, I don't remember the name, Stronger, Faster, or something. He said that the two traits, it's natural ability and be teachable, and that's a big one. Okay, so if you really, and this everybody can be it, okay? You just, by the way, discipline, higher commitment, teachable are mental thing. You can be that, okay? You can just wake up one day and decide to be it, and you're gonna be amazing. So it come from you, and everybody can be it. It's just a decision that you make on yourself. Now, intelligence, this is not what you decide to do or not. Intelligence, it's not only intelligence, it's intuition, and fighting intuition, high IQ, I will say. Intelligence in the sense that you need to understand that your sensei is teaching you a blueprint, and you need to modify and when you reach purple belt, you need to modify and adjust and understand that you need to create your own jiu-jitsu. And fighting high IQ, it's very important, and a high level is something that's gonna make the difference between winning and losing against people that are more or less the same level. Because reaching the highest level, like ADCC World, for example, I think that the difference between Gordon Ryan and everybody else is the high IQ is in fighting, and. And yes, so that's very important. I'm joking. Maybe I'm gonna delete that video. Oops. I don't want to have a problem with him. But yeah, it's a very important treat, okay? And this is, you have it or you don't have it, that's it. So now we have the two, a flashy one, okay? The two that everybody dreamed, that everybody like wished you have, and you can see in the comic books, okay? It's fast assimilation. In Naruto, you see that very often. The guy see a movement one time, or in Dragon Ball Z, the guy see a movement one time, he can repeat right away. Amazing! And that you have a physical ability like Superman, okay? Typical Superman, Flash, people that have crazy strength and everything. But in reality, yeah, just flashy. They just impress the girls, impress the white belt and maybe the blue belt. But any purple, brown, black know that this is just flashy. They are just impressing, but they may never go far if they don't have discipline. Okay, we said discipline beat talent, but for me, discipline it's a talent. Okay, trust me, it's a talent. It's a mental talent that is more potent than fast assimilation physical ability, okay? This is what you need to fucking understand, okay? Oh, I'm not gifted. You can be gifted, okay? Start here. Giftedness start here, buddy. Start with discipline and higher commitment and being teachable. These three that are the three more powerful talents, It's talents that you decide to have, that you can put on whenever you decide, okay? And then you have a high IQ fight that, again, this can still be learned with time. Some people have a higher IQ naturally and will always have a higher IQ than other people. It is what it is, okay? There is something called innate talent, and it's a higher IQ, fast assimilation, and physical ability. But these talents are not turning on if you are not have discipline, higher commitment, and being teachable, okay? They are just flashy if you don't have that. They're impressing people, okay? But that's it. So every time someone, every time you ask yourself if you have talents, my answer is you can have it if you want, okay? And intelligence, fast assimilation, listen, if you really want to develop intelligence, you can watch videos, you can read the rules, you can think about jiu-jitsu and try to understand jiu-jitsu as a technical aspect. And then they're gonna increase your intelligence and your IQ fight, okay? That's it. So even intelligence, it can be increased if you desire, okay? And that's it. I want to talk a little bit more about fast assimilation and physical ability, because... So the two flashy ability, okay? You can, even if you didn't come with jiu-jitsu with it, you can still have it, okay? Fast assimilation. Watch video of technique, fancy technique, and try to repeat them. Not in the fight, try to repeat them when you drill it on your own with friends, with the time that you have to decide to teach your brain to learn patterns and movement, complex movement. And then when the sensei gonna show you easier technique, it's gonna be easier to assimilate. So again, you can fast assimilation. It's some people have it naturally, some people can learn it. I don't have it naturally, but now I have it. I can watch the technique and almost repeat it without looking again. And this is because years of doing martial art. Physical ability. Listen, let's be honest, a jiu-jitsu guy doesn't grow the full potential of his strength, okay? Nobody, because it's a waste of time. But if you really you feel that you are a little bit too weak, spend 3 hours a week to the gym for 5 years, you're gonna be so much stronger than the average dude in jiu-jitsu, man. Forget about it. And when it comes to cardio, just don't fucking take a rest. Fight until you die, okay? And if you are exhausted, put your ego to the side and let the people submit you and still try again and again and again, okay? And what else? Speed is timing in jiu-jitsu. Speed, it's useless to be fast. I mean, fast is good, but most of the time being fast is to have the right timing, is to have the right moment to fire. That's it, okay? So so you see, physical ability, you can still find a way to have it. And just to be clear, don't fucking use steroid, because steroid gonna fuck up your entire life. And after jiu-jitsu, even if you decide to be a world champion, after jiu-jitsu, you're still gonna want to have a life with family and everything. And if your body is fucked up because for 5-10 years of your life you decide to do jiu-jitsu and you decide to use steroid, for me, I think that steroid, it's a mental weakness, okay? It's a lack of discipline. It's the lack of discipline. So you are, by taking steroid, you're showing a lack of discipline. So you're showing that you don't have the most important talent. But other than that, there is one that need to have it or you don't have it. But again, you need to have it to be the best in the world, not to be a badass, okay? If you really want to aim number one in ADCC world, I think this is one that makes the difference. The talent that for me at make the difference between the number one, the number two, the number three, or the number 10 is the fight IQ. So it's not that you have it or you don't have it. Yes, it is. No, it is not. I'm gonna explain. You can develop your IQ, your fight IQ, okay? With time, you're increasing your fight IQ. But there's this thing called intuition, and I can see we on the other fighter and everything. Sometimes you have it or you don't have it, or you already have it to a certain level and you can grow it, but someone that already had it a high level will grow it higher. So your fight IQ is here and is the other guy is here, and we're gonna both grow our fight IQ. So if he doesn't train and everything, I'm gonna surpass him, but if he train as much as me, is that fight IQ will always, because fight IQ is, it's also intuition. It also understand the timing, the moment. It's something complex, okay? It's seeing patterns right away, subconsciously, and be able to assimilate the movement to catch the guy, seeing the guy out of balance faster. It's something that you can, of course, increase. But definitely there's people that have a higher fight IQ than others. And I think that what makes the difference between Gordon Ryan, Greg Jones, Maya Sebastos, Bianca, Fiona, it's Buchecha, is that they have a higher fight IQ, okay? Okay, Buchecha is crazy strong and he has a crazy card and he's a monster. I don't think that's the reason why he's so good. Of course, it helps and he's dedicated and he has all the other attributes that I tell you that you can have. But it's the fight IQ that make the difference between him and anybody else that train as much, that are as much talented and everything. The difference between him being world champion and other being second, third place is the fight IQ. And yes, you can still develop it, you can still increase it, okay? I increase my fight IQ from a lot, okay, and I still try to increase it. But sometimes I can see people that have a higher fight IQ, they're gonna go further than me, and if they train as much than me, and that's it. And That's the one that make the big difference, I think, more than the shiny one.